What's up, EGC Nation? It's your boy, Script the Legend, bringing y'all another YouTube video. Market cap of $867 million, and the price dropped last night. We had a freaking nuke dropped on us last night. We went from 5021 down to 501763, which isn't a lot, but it's a lot. When you think about where the price was, and then when you really break it down into like percentages, that is a lot. That's 0.4 down, but we still good. People are trying to buy and eat the dip up. People are selling though. Someone just sold like $8,000 worth of Evergrow coin, and it's because someone sold $6,700 of Evergrow coin, and it's because of the comments of what was said in the AMA. And if you actually notice, we thought like the AMA dip that was happening was bad, but then when you see this, you're like, that's freaking no. That's like I said, that was a freaking no. We're still going in holders though. 93,800 holders today, this morning. Trading volume of $12.5 million according to CoinGecko, and trading volume of $14.9 million according to CoinMarketCap. And CoinMarketCap, man, I can't stand them. But I was reading the comments. But this is what Evergrow Coin released yesterday. We thought this perhaps requires some further explanation. Just a quick note, because if people buy on a centralized exchange, they will initially avoid tax, but any tokens they buy will then automatically get excluded from rewards. That means less tokens available or eligible for rewards. So more BUSD for those receiving rewards. This will coincide with the launch of our utilities, which will in turn generate massive buyback and burn, far more than we've seen so far, which means more rewards for all eligible wallets and even more supply removed from rewards eligibility circulation. It will very quickly become very attractive for those people on centralized exchanges to make the transfer to a rewards eligible wallet. That move will be automatically taxed, contributing more rewards. Remember, many traders and investors only exist on centralized exchanges, so this will open up millions of potential new investors to the idea of Evergrow Coin, who will in turn become aware and wish to participate in an ever improving reward system. It's a win-win-win. We just think it's taking a little time for people to fully understand the scope of this. And the more and more I think of this, the more and more of a good idea it is to me. And then I also think of some of the drawbacks as well, though. You have to be realistic. I can't just be an investor of this crypto or just an investor in general and not look at the positives and the negatives. And I'm sure they looked at the positives and the negatives, too. The negatives are that when they buy in, we're not going to see any of those rewards, because one of the things that we was excited about when it came to like being listed on Binance and Coinbase and all those other exchanges, we knew like those people were going to buy in massive amounts of Evergrow coin, and it was going to just be amazing for us, because we was going to have some crazy trading volume, and we was going to see some crazy, we was going to get some crazy money, man. But with us being on exchanges and those people buying in but not getting taxed when they buy in, then it doesn't really help us. But what it does help us with is raise the market cap. So it raises the value of the Evergrow coin we are holding. But as you've seen on the calculator, market cap does not relate to the amount of tokens you're receiving in reflections. So the BUSD will not change, but the trading volume could change. But then in turn, you still have the utilities, and the utilities are going to be burning cryptos and buying, doing the buyback and the burn, which does reward us holders. The more people that are invested into Evergrow coin, it does, or use the utilities, it does help us. So yes, there's going to be a big whales that come in, right? They're going to buy massive amount. And one thing I don't know if they made clear or not, but when they sell, I feel like if you tell me this, then I'll be cool. But if they don't get taxed when they initially buy in, but if they sell, are they taxed on their way out? Because if they're taxed on their way out, then I'm cool. All right, they going to try to buy it, and they're going to try to sell on the rise and stuff. But then I'm going to get their taxes. I'm going to get paid a bank. I'm going to get paid bank from that. And then I'm still making the utilities rewards, because the utilities is going to remove tokens from circulation. And the utilities are also going to be buying back even more and more crypto coins into the of Evergrow coin, and just make it even, give me even more rewards. So I can see why people sold, but I don't see why. I think people should think of the long term. Because a lot of y'all were worried about, and it's kind of hypocritical of some of you, some of us investors, because some people were like, well, are you sure you want to stick to not having tokenomics everywhere? Like, are you sure you want to stick to having tokenomics everywhere we go? Because that's going to keep us from being on Coinbase and some other exchanges. And now people are like doubling back, like, wait, no. We want the tokenomics. We don't want the central exchanges. But guys, the central exchanges are going to raise our price even more and get us introduced to even more and more holders, because that's no key one of the things that hold back SafeMoon. Like, so we're gonna have the Shiba. I'm sorry. I hope you guys can still see my screen. But guys, we're gonna have the Shiba volume, and then we're gonna have the BUSD. We're gonna have the rewards from a better SafeMoon, in my opinion. And then we're gonna have utilities. So everything is all right, everything is good. The total distributed BUSD after all that is $21.3 million, and it's gonna keep growing. There's been more tokens burned as well, guys. Please do your due diligence. Please think this out thoroughly before you sell. But on a light note, I've created a Twitch channel. It is scripted_legend_live. Go follow me. I'm still customizing my page. I want y'all to go follow me. I'm going to start doing my streams over on that on that platform. But then, don't worry. Even if, for those who don't know about Twitch, or that they're not familiar with Twitch and they don't want to go over to Twitch, Keep in mind that I'm going to go live on Twitch, and then I'm going to transfer or export my video files from Twitch's stream to YouTube, so y'all can still watch it and see what was said in there, and then y'all can possibly consider joining. Here's another good thing to look at when it comes to Evergrow coin. A lot of altcoins are down right now. Bitrise is down. From my understanding, crypto is down. A lot of cryptos, altcoins are down. But the ones that are up are the big dogs. You got the XRP, you got the Bitcoin, you got the Ethereum. Those are what's up today. So don't look at this dip as like the end of Evergrow coin and where everybody that believed in Evergrow coin is leaving. No. Because even look at this. The holders are going up. So people are leaving Evergrow coin, but some new holders are coming in. The people that actually believe in the project and want to see this thing through to the end are buying in. And then the people that don't want to be here and they're worried, they're scared. I'm not going to call them paper hands, but they don't like the direction Evergrow coin is going in right now. They're the ones that's selling. And you don't want those people part of the boat, because in the chats, it's not going to build a nice welcoming community, because you're going to have people that are like, I don't know what Evergrow Coin's doing, but welcome to the team. Then you're going to have new investors like looking at it sideways like, okay, so is the team good or not? Like, I kind of bought into this coin because they have a better team than Shiba, but they're getting listed on exchanges like Shiba. So, guys, Binance is even more likely to happen. Coinbase is more likely to happen. Other big exchanges are more likely to happen now. So thank you guys for watching. Remember to follow me over on Twitch, and y'all have a blessed one. Stay safe, and always remember,
one last thing, tell them to bring me my money. Yeah!